you, Dr. Chaudhary.
Yeah, good evening to all of you. I would like to take you through a topic which is going to impact our nation. And if we are able to leverage the concept that I'm going to discuss, I can assure you that it can accelerate the GDP growth of our nation. Now, just to cite you a few statistics, 70% of world population will be living in cities by 2050. But if you look at short term, that's next 6 years, one third of the biggest cities that you're going to see in the world, they don't exist today. Which means many cities are going to be engineered. And it is a great opportunity to ensure that these cities are created and that they are smart. The second problem which can be addressed is actually the cities that we live in today, how do you make them more sustainable? How do you make them more livable? I'd like to just share with you that two aspects, I think, which needs a lot of attention and which will receive a lot of attention. One is the role of regulators, the role of compliance. You will find that the requirement of compliance is going to increase in the days to come and in the years to come. We might draw plans which are revolutionary. We might draw plans which are commercially attractive. But if we do not listen to the voice of the citizens, it might happen that many of those great plans approved by the financial institutions and stakeholders may actually get jeopardized. I'll share with you subsequently, how can you really win the heart of citizens to really get buy-in for your projects? Many of our projects today, as all of you know, in northeast part of the country are actually jeopardized because they are not receiving the support of the citizens. Go down south, there are several nuclear initiatives which are receiving resistance from citizens. So the issue is, how do you really receive the support of citizens for large initiatives that many of us believe can transform our country? Now, friends, I'd like to share with you, a time has come when science should not only be taught in the schools and universities, but science is actually got to be applied in real life to make our world a better place to live in. Now, friends, I'd like to share with you just a few questions, right? If we want to build cities which are sustainable, in fact, our new government has declared its intention to build 100 smart cities. If we want to build our cities sustainable, it is very important that we are able to anticipate the impact of our decisions in the physical world, and we should be doing it in the virtual world, because the cost of taking a wrong decisions in the physical world, in the real world, is very, very high. Today, technologies are available which enable you to actually simulate the projects that you are planning to do. We have done studies in different parts of the world, and I would like to share with you that the engineering time, the time that you take to engineer a plant, the time that you take to plan a city, the time that you take to probably engineer a process plant, you can reduce it by almost one third by using the concept of virtualization. You can reduce the time that you take to construct a power station, could be a generation plant, could be a transmission unit, or could be a distribution setup. If it is a big setup, studies have been conducted to demonstrate that if you virtually construct the plant, then you can anticipate the risk that you are going to see during the actual construction of the plant. So the time for construction can actually be reduced through virtualization. I would like to...
Slides are not coming. Can you fix that? He's showing the slides which are not coming on the screen.
இருக்குது யூஎஸ்பி ஒன்று இருக்குது
It's not coming. It's not reading. Are you using PP?
Yeah, he just took it.
Yeah. I'll just give it from there.
Yeah, friends, I mean, as they get connected, I just wanted to show you a simple video clip to share with you that today you can actually create in three dimension. You can create a city. You can define the relationship, the requirement of energy, the requirement of water. You can define how are you going to manage the waste, how are you going to design your infrastructure. You can actually simulate the safety requirement. In fact, there are these technologies also enable you to predict where do you have a security threat. Are you likely to have probably a terrorist attack today, this evening? So these technologies can actually enable you to simulate that if you build a new city, what is going to be the requirement of the education system? What is going to be the requirement of education? You can actually do a prediction on what is going to be the relationship between educated employees coming out and the job requirement. You can actually look at the relationship between when you lay a new metro line, how the habitation in that area is going to increase and what will be the increased demand on healthcare. You can actually simulate that if you want to breed, if you want to build green buildings.
Doctor,
what?
Come to the slide. They are now connected from there. Which slide you are? You just tell them they will put it there and then.
Yeah, okay. I'm in fourth slide.
Fourth. You said fourth slide. Yeah. You said this slide, they will change there.
Okay.
Sorry about this. We are talking about high technology and the simple thing is not misbehaving.
Fourth.
End of the day.
Into the fourth. So what I was just trying to say, at least the 10 dimensions, if you look at the dimensions of energy, the dimensions of water, the dimensions of how are you going to manage the wastewater, the dimensions of infrastructure, public safety, security, education, healthcare, green building, the need for transportation, and the services that you provide to the citizens. Now, a city is actually a mother of several such subsystems. You can simulate the behavior of the city with the help of such virtualization. We have conducted several studies, and we have shown that you can actually anticipate the impact of your decisions on this on such models. Now, if you go to Northeast, I was interacting with many citizens. They truly believe that if there is an earthquake, many of the dams that we are planning to build, they might collapse, and they will be subjected to flood, and generations would die. In such technology, you can actually simulate that if there is an earthquake, a real earthquake, and let's say 8 on the Richter scale or 9 on the Richter scale, you can actually shake them and see, are they really going to collapse? So you can actually do scientific analysis, and you can digitally show such dams to the citizens using a technology called virtual reality platform. So the citizens will able to see that how is their environment today in terms of health, safety, education, and how the environment is going to be when such projects are rolled out. You will actually be able to do what we call as democratization of innovation. You'll be able to involve the potential and beneficiaries in the innovation process. Now, another aspect that I wanted to highlight is what we call as the transport system efficiency. You can actually make assessment of the transport system efficiency. Today, if you go to cities like Gurgaon, you actually see a huge traffic. Now, such thing can actually be simulated, and you can take preventive actions in advance. Now, I would just show you a video clip just to give you a feel that how they look like. And this is a project. We did it in a city called City of Lyon in France. And over there, the water system, the can you click that? Can you click that slide? Can you just click that? Yeah. So over there in the city of Lyon, they were able to actually see the entire city in 3D and the various changes that the city administrators were planning to do. They are able to see the impact of those decisions in terms of pollution, in terms of water requirement, in terms of new systems they were planning to manage the garbage, how the disposal system is going to be. They were able to simulate how is going to be the traffic and what is going to be the improvement in the traffic system when those decisions are implemented. Now, what really happens when you conceive a new project? If you are able to demonstrate the benefit of the project in three dimensions, the appreciation by the citizens increases. And even for organizations which is looking forward to approval from regulatory bodies, the appreciation by the authorities increases when they are able to actually visualize this in front of them. In fact, in this technology today, when you see such a project in the digital environment, you feel as if it is absolutely real. The only thing you cannot do is to touch it and feel it or smell it because it is digital. So, this is briefly what I wanted to share with you. And this concept, we are implementing it in 12 different sectors, and one of them being energy process, utility, and urban planning.